to give him a couple of ideas for his clothing company. He hasn't given me more information. Therefore, I'm going to give what I think is an appropriate logo and a name for a clothing store. We went ahead and chose an eco-chic clothing store. We're all about organic, all about green, and trying to preserve what we can of the world. You're going to open a canvas, and on your canvas, you're going to go to your shapes and lines, and you're gonna scroll down. You're going to go find an arch up shape. You're gonna add it to your design, and you're gonna change the color and make it a bright green. So you are going to make this a little bit bigger because we're creating a hanger. We're creating a hanger for our design. Align it and add it to the middle of the page. Just reduce it slightly. And then select it and duplicate it again and change the color to make it white. One of these days, we're not doing this once we get some functionality with Affinity. Anyway, for now, we do what we can with what we have. So reduce the middle of the shape to create a nice, beautiful hanger shape. You can group the two shapes and then go back to your elements and search for a triangle. Add your triangle and increase the size of your triangle. Also change the shape of it to the green that we're using. And then make your corners a little bit rounded. And then spread your triangle. Bring this a little bit up. And go ahead and duplicate that shape. Add a second triangle. Do similar to what you've done with the shape. And then press T for text to add the name of the business. We're going to use a font called FB Ecologia for this one. And we write the name of the business, increase the size so that it fits in with our design on the handle. And add a circle for a small, beautiful full stop as part of our design. And then we add clothing, and we're going to use a font called Economica for that. Design purposes, you can add a different color on the full stop, and we can make it red, so it's up to you where you want to go with it. I just like diversity with my designs. And there's your design. Simple, minimalistic, beautiful design. You're going to have to take off the white shape. So you're going to download the design as a 2D and then upload it back on Canva to remove the extra shapes we've added on. So if you don't have Canva Pro, you know by now, you can always use my trial for 30 days to do the removals of the extra shapes we're adding on the design. You're gonna click on edit photo. I know this is gonna go away soon, so while we still have it, we're gonna use the old editor, and we're going to remove the extra whites that are on there. We click on apply, and then we're gonna download this as a transparent background, and now we want page 2 so that we can convert it to 3D. We're going to log in on photopea.com, and we're going to use templates. Remember, you can always showcase using mockups on Canva or smart mockups. It's up to you. I'd love to use this mockup. You're going to open it up, click on the link and have it open up. Once it has loaded, you're going to double click where it says your logo here on the checkered box. And you're going to hide the example shown by the designer of the mockup. You're going to go to your downloads and grab your design. Make it nice and huge in a similar way that you've seen the designer of the mockup has showed you. Align it and then press Command S or Control S to convert it to a smart object. And click on the first tab to access your design. It just looks absolutely stunning. Simple, beautiful. You're going to click on File, Export, and you choose the type of file that you want to export it as. And as simple as that, you're done. You can always go to our playlist to get much more design. We will be loading more for you, Programmer Charlie, to give you more ideas on your clothing store. We're trying to go organic. Thank you for joining me today. I will see you on our next video.